Yeah, obviously I had a disappointing week there at Lords. Physically bowled quite a few overs in those two test matches, so it was important to rest up a little bit for the first part of the week, and then get in the gym and do some running leading into to Edgbaston, because it's going to be a really big week for us. I mean, I've seen that England haven't won the third test of a Ashes series since 1981, which is quite remarkable, really. So it's time we turn that around, and we've got a good record here. The last test match I played here, Cookie got 294, I think. So we should have some good memories of playing here, and hopefully we'll start well on Wednesday. When you're playing in a series as big as this, you're in it for that 8 weeks, 9 weeks. So you're obviously never going to be able to switch away too much from it, but you want to come to every game feeling fresh, and that means physically fresh, but mentally fresh as well. So it's tricky, because even when you're at home or you nip for a coffee or something, because cricket's in the papers, people are talking about it, so everyone wants to have a quick chat about it. So you're never going to get away from it, but just gathering with the guys this morning, everyone feels excited to get going. We had a really big opportunity after Cardiff to play well at Lords and set ourselves up in this series. Unfortunately, it didn't go that way, but that's sport. I think a few days after the test, I think people got a little bit carried away with, it's like we were losing 10-0 in a five-match series. So it is 1-1, there's three test matches left, and both teams are quite similar, I think. Like to play attacking cricket, like to play with a bit of flair, and I think it bodes well for the rest of the series. Yeah, everyone's really excited. I mean, obviously, when you've had a loss like Lords, you're desperate to get back on the field and put it right. So that it just sort of sparks up training a bit. The competitive edge will be there. And desperate to get out here Wednesday. I mean, it's probably one of the loudest grounds we play at Edgbaston. The crowd always get right behind us. I've got fantastic memories of seeing sort of Spider-Man climb up these poles behind us and things. So the guys like playing here. Guys have got good records here, and hopefully we'll start well.